Over the last week, I filmed in the forest, I filmed in a sports car manufacturer, and tomorrow I'm off down to the sea. All different clients, all different projects. So how to keep tabs on all of these different things going on without getting confused or missing something within it all? Let me just throw down my trusty f-stop sloper bag. I love this thing, and then I'll show you. So over the last couple of years, I've been trying to find the answer to the problem of multiple productions running at the same time, people sending you documents in all different places, and trying to keep a kind of oversight on client work, my own work, and the courses that I create, as well as YouTube content. If you're creative like me, you know that trying to get some sort of mental clarity over your business is actually quite difficult. But now I can say, after a couple of weeks of testing, I have found a solution, or more to the point, I've designed a solution. So welcome to my Notion project management system. So this is how I operate across all of my content. So in here, you will see I have courses, projects, original ideas, my accounts, salvation on set notes, I'll explain that in a minute, clients and contacts, and then here I just have a very quick way of writing down ideas. So I'll show you where that comes up in a minute, but for instance, let me do an example. So a film idea, that film idea might be, you know, a new James Bond film, James Bond 008. So save that, then you'll see, got another idea, I can keep going. But before I run, let me walk you through everything that I have. So I didn't drink enough water, as I'm told by everyone. So I now have put in a counter to keep me on track. So you can see here, I can just count up and keep on top of that, and then just reset at the start of every day, nice and easy. I have a clock and also a percentage of the month and the year that's gone by. So you can actually, there's a way of making this kind of go shorter or longer. You can do days, weeks, or years, or lifetime. You can even do a lifetime. To me, that's a bit scary. But a year is a really good indicator for me to kind of keep on tabs of where I am with where I'm trying to get to. So I'll come back to courses in a minute, because projects is where most of you guys will be interested. This is where my main stuff happens. Now, out of respect to my clients, I've not got all of my actual projects in here, but I've got an example one that I'm going to walk you through. So up the top, I have a projects tally, so I can keep tabs of how many projects I'm doing throughout a year, throughout a month. So it's a matter of personal preference, but I do it by year. And I've also put in a footage hard drive directory. The amount of times lately that I've had to try and find an old project and not knowing what hard drive it's on, I got sick of it. So I created this hard drive directory. So now any project, let's say I want to know where FE2 is, I can type it in. I know it's on my Lacey 2 hard drive. And similarly, you know, you could wonder what is on your Lacey 2 hard drive, and then it will tell you that way. And you can see I've got two projects on there, for instance. So in the actual yearly project files, what I have is the commercials, documentary, and narrative split separately, so I can keep that a little bit, you know, mentally, just compartmentalize that. And then I have the ability to, again, filter through name, client, or the stages at post-production, production, you get it. Now, I've built this entire system. It's taken me quite a long time, but in a way that is efficient and not just works for me, but I can collaborate with other people. So I can bring on my producer or my DP, share these files, and then they can just figure it out without me having to explain it too much. First off, I have my to-do list, and then I split this by client, director, producer, you know, give everyone very clear what they have to do. And I always have some sort of shoot checklist beforehand. So just to kind of make sure I'm not forgetting all the simple things, you know, like your batteries and your cards. Then I have my key dates. In here, I'll make sure that I know all the key dates that are, you know, kickoff meeting, when the auditions are, you know, shoot dates, anything like that, that will go in here. And you can view that as a list or calendar, you know, the kind of options up to you. Then I have my creative docs, and this will be what I'll share with a client or DP, and I'll literally just have the documents embedded in here. So it's really easy for anyone to kind of just see this, download it, gain access. And, you know, here I've put in an example of one of my favorite films, which is Lion, Love this film. And so you can see I've just got the whole screenplay embedded in here, which if you haven't read it, go read it. Really good screenplay. And then mood board, storyboard, lighting plan. They're the main creative documents I like to have because I'm always using them. Beneath that, I'll put in any references. So here, I just needed to put in something I could use. So I put in my own film. But you know, I drop in films from Vimeo, films from YouTube. Then I'll write what I like about them. And then if I'm working with a DP or someone and you know, I wanna kind of get their input, I'll ask them to comment on it so they can kind of leave their own thoughts in there. So that's the references. And then I have budget and mileage. Now this is very, very handy, particularly if you are a numbers person, or probably even better if you're not a numbers person and you need to be. So I break things down into the budget, obviously, and then pre-production, production post, because it would be post-production, but it's alphabetical. So in the top half, I have the production tracker, and that gives me the overview of the whole thing. And then beneath that, I have the expenditure, so I can keep a track of every single thing going through. Now, I've just mocked this up. This is not a real production here. But you can see that, you know, cam op for £600 per day, 2 days, £1,200. With everything added up, I'm looking at £1,700. So I've still got £6,300 left. Great. I've also set this up so you can toggle through your expenses. So you can, you know, just look at how much one area is costing. And this whole thing took me quite a while to make work, but now I have, does the job really well. And beneath that, I'll have my mileage. So I will keep a track of all the mileage from a job. And I will use this as basically a calculator and using a Google Maps timeline. So looking at the past of all of my driving from that job, whack it in here, find out the total, put it on the invoice, happy days. Now, my favorite part of the entire thing that I've created here is in the casting system. So when you get actors apply, you get so many. And the last short I did was really good. We had a good system going between the producer and I in Google Docs, but I wanted to create something a little bit easier, a little bit kind of less friction in terms of actually looking through everyone's individual portfolio. So now I have it where in here, you can just add an actor. So inside you can have their showreel, any notes, their email, contact address, all of that. And you can also shortlist people. So if I wanted to say, I wanted to throw in a load of actors and I wanted someone else's opinion, they could filter through by who the actor is and, you know, they can say yes or no. And then I can come back and see who they've chosen. I love this as a system. It works amazingly. Doesn't matter if you work on your own or in a pair or even like a small team, or even want to bring a client onto this page just to do that. It is just such an efficient way of working that kind of makes you look infinitely more professional. And then I've done the same thing with locations as well, but I've changed this to have you got permission granted yet? And in there, I will put the you know, the point of contact, Samantha Leafington, and the cost, the email, the permission. So same thing really. Just side note, if you are interested, I am actually selling this whole system as a template that you can buy with a 25% discount right now. So I'll leave a link to that down below. So now the other production docs I have are call sheets. So I have set this up actually. So if you did want to download this, then the you can either create a production call sheet in Notion. I have done this and you know it does work well. You can put in Google Maps and you can fill in all the details that you need, the timings, the, you know, who needs to be where, when, even a weather link. I actually personally prefer to just embed a call sheet in there because I like my call sheets that I use. But, you know, it's kind of user-friendly in both regards there. Now to keep on track of a bit more of the kind of almost like the AD side of things, I have a shot list that I will create in Notion. So I will go through and I will put in the location, the shot, the angle, the description. And once I've finished, I can literally just come up, print it off, export it as a PDF, and it looks like just a normal shot list, you know, nice, easy table. But what's nice is if I wanted to filter this off for whatever reason, so I can literally just show what's getting shot in the bedroom, you know, if you wanted to do it that way. Yeah, so that's how I keep on track of my shot list. And similarly, a bit different, but similar, I have an equipment list. And in here, I break it down to the department and the quantity and who's supplying it. So on a lot of my work, it's not just my equipment. We're relying on other people to bring equipment, or we're renting it in. And this here is how I can make sure I know who's responsible for what, who's collecting what item from where. And what I really like about it is I can actually say I've got a runner helping out on the day, and if I give them access to this, they can just type in their own name and then they will know exactly just what they need to bring. So it kind of filters that out for them. And obviously with this, you have to go through and change it. Like as with any production, you have to change it for the job itself, because not every job's gonna need the same equipment. But that's been, again, really helpful in just making sure that when you get to the set, you're not all going, I thought you were bringing the ProMist. No, I thought you were, I thought you were. I've been there and I don't wanna be there again. So the other documents that I tend to have is my insurance, a COVID disclaimer, release forms ready to go, and allergies and dietary requirement. So as a vegan, I've experienced this a lot lately, productions that tend to overlook people's food requirements. Now with me, I'm relatively easygoing. I mean, obviously I don't eat meat, but if I was allergic, it's a bit more of a problem. So what I have is a allergies dietary requirement list here that I can build up of everyone in the team, and then that way I know who requires what when. And if I'm not handling the catering, because often I'm not, I can print this off and give it to whoever is handling the catering, and then it's just done, it's sorted, everyone knows what is needed for everyone else. It is important in my mind to consider these things. It's just the small things that go a long way. You know, I did a short film in January and they gave me some of the best vegan food I've ever had. And, you know, I was doing that job as a favor for a friend, simply for the fact that they treated me so well in terms of, you know, just caring about me as a person and my values. That made a big difference to me. That went a long way. So if you can, always recommend putting in that time there. And then I have my edits and amends. So in here, I'll have the date of when everything's due, and I will have what is due. So whether it's 16:9, vertical, square, I'll have the length needed, you know, 10 seconds, 30 seconds, whatever it is. And if I want to, I'm pretty good at just checking in and looking, but I do sometimes set myself a reminder just like 2 days before, so I never forget when a deadline is up. You don't want to miss your deadlines. That is, it's like rule number one. If you miss a deadline, that's the easiest way to lose a client. So don't do it. Now, the other thing that I've added that I really like is I use frame.io for client review. There is a free account, by the way. So if you don't have any money, but you want to use frame.io, I would recommend it. And this is just one of their demo videos here. You can embed the player for the review link within Notion. So within here, now within one system, I can see all the notes that the clients are leaving. Now at this point in time, you can't leave comments from within Notion that will show up on frame.io. Hopefully that integration will happen at some point down the line, but you can at least read them. So for me, this is really useful because I just want to see all the comments coming in. And then when I have that meeting with the client, I can be like, okay, let's go through all these points. I don't tend to write many comments on frame.io. I tend to more just be reading them and kind of noting them down. Yeah, so I really like that feature. And then you can full screen it, so you get a bit more of a pleasing aesthetic, as it were. So that's how I manage all of my projects within Notion, but that's not all I do here. And that's the main part, but there's so much more you can do. So I also have all my courses in here. So for instance, all my Skillshare courses, when I'm coming up with them and when I'm kind of working on them, I will have them down in this table and I will have the stage that they're at and the date that I'm planning to launch it. And then within here, you can go in and make notes. So I'll have another table with my course outline, key takeaways. I also have original ideas. So this is where any ideas I have for my own content, whether that is a YouTube video. So in here, I will have key dates, whether that is social or global or personal for YouTube content. And then beneath that, I will have my ideas. And again, you can go in, leave notes. I'll have what I'm planning to do next, what's performed really well. And I'll do that with all the other different types of content. So in the short films tab, for instance, then you'll see the idea that we mentioned right at the start from the homepage has popped up in here. And then beneath that, I will have any of the projects that I'm working on. So I've just created this fake project here. Now, the logistics page is very similar to everything in my commercial page. You know, there's no real change there. But the creative is where things are a bit different. So I will have the concept with the overall story. This is just a fake short film idea I've made up. So feel free to, you know, if you want to pause and read it or whatever. But then, yeah, I have the themes, the tone of voice, and I create my beat sheets in here. So for those of you who are into film writing, this is a great way of kind of getting your story structure down, having your act one, act two, act three, and being able to just move these key points around. This is actually what I did with my TV pilot screenplay that won that big competition back in 2021. So, you know, this is proven to work for me, and I'm sure it will work for you as well. The rest are exactly the same, so, you know, don't need to go into that really. The accounts is where things get a little bit more interesting. So I keep a tabs of all my invoices in here. I don't create my invoices in Notion. You can, but I think it's a bit clunky. I prefer to just create them using the software I have already and then keep a tabs on all of them in here. So knowing when they're due, have they been paid, have I uploaded it to my accountant software? And then I have my actual accounts. So in here, I will keep an annual mileage. That's really important because after, at least in the UK, after 10,000 miles, you can only charge 25p per mile. And then I'll normally put my financial goals for the tax year. And then beneath that, I have very similar to the budget tracker for productions, but this is for my business as a whole. So in the lower tab, I have every month split up, and you will see that I have it split up by the date, what type of income it is, if it's a freelance or Skillshare, what my expenses are, keeping a track of all of that, how much in, how much out, any notes, what I've spent it on, and again, have I uploaded the receipt to my accountant. And then up here, this all auto-calculates. So the only thing is sometimes it doesn't seem to kind of do it straight away, so I have to refresh the page. But this is a very small thing, just refreshing the page once in a while sorts it out. So as you can see, March last year, I spent almost as much as I brought in. If you're wondering why, I bought a lot of equipment, including two matching cameras, some tentacle sinks, matte box and filters. I just went all out really because I wanted it, I needed it. It makes my life easier. And then I kind of keep going through the months like that and just become aware of how much I'm actually spending and how much I'm bringing in. Without that oversight, it can be quite difficult to know where your business is going. So I find that to be really helpful. Since I started doing it, it's been quite eye-opening. So that's the accounts. Just quickly, if you're enjoying this, you're new to the channel, feel free to like, subscribe. Always nice to have new people around. And the last two things is my clients and contacts, which I've just created some fake ones here. If you are in Europe, then be aware of GDPR with storing clients. But sometimes you want to build a good relationship with your client. It's nice to kind of keep those key little details in mind. You can write notes about what they like, little things to kind of build up that relationship a little bit more. And again, just, you know, like email, website, more standard stuff. And finally, what I think is really important, it's just a place to have quick access when you're on a job using equipment that you don't know. This is where I add all of that detail. So this week just gone, I was in charge of making sure all the Asteria tubes were connecting and working in the background of this interview. It's a very important interview and can't really afford for them to go wrong. But anyone who's used the Astera app understands it's not that great. So I went ahead and I created myself a step-by-step guide. So just on the day, I'm not going to be caught out. I'm not going to wonder what to do if things go wrong. And actually, I did use this on the day just to double check one thing. The more prepared you can be going into a job, the better a job you're going to do, the more likely you are to get a job out the other side. And then I will also put in a video, an emergency video, I like to call it, which is just if I'm really stuck, I have at least one link to a video that kind of walks you through how to do the whole setup. And similarly, if there's a role that you don't really know what to do, I'll just put it in the notes here. So, you know, an AD, what do they say? You go turnover, sound speed, camera rolling, market. They don't say all those things, but that's the order that happens before action. So yeah, essentially, this is a place to keep a track of all my finances, all my projects, both original, client, keep notes. So on any job, I've always got the solution, build up course ideas, kind of build strong relationship with clients. And the best bit about it is that Notion, the software that does all of this, is free. So you can use this completely for free for up to 5 people to work on the same channel, as it were. So if you have a team of 5 people, you can use this for free. Or if you want to bring in 4 other people, that's great. If you are a solo filmmaker, then you can, you know, bring in a client or 2 at a time, maybe that one person who's your regular assistant. You can also build beyond that, though. There are paid systems within Notion. Now, I created this for me as a working film director DP. I created this to solve the problem that I was having. But, you know, I don't want to just keep it for myself. So I am putting it out there into the world. So if you like this, then there is a template available and I am going to do 25% off. So if you want that, there's a link in the description. And there's also a link for the first 15 people, I will give this completely free. So there's another separate link. You just have to make sure you are quick to hit that. This setup has ripped out all the barriers that I was having and streamlined my entire workflow from pre-production in terms of conceptualization and also working with a producer on a regular basis all the way through to post-production and making sure that, you know, I'm building a good business overall. It's taken me ages to kind of get this to where it is now, but now I have it, I freaking love it. And also, I'm actually doing something where you can become an affiliate for it if you want. So if you like it and you want to kind of share it around with your friends, then once you purchase this software, there is a sign-up link that you can use to actually become an affiliate. My goal is to make film more accessible and more pleasant for everyone. And so we're not just spending hundreds of thousands of pounds on yearly subscription models for CRM systems that aren't really even designed for creatives like us. I wanted something that is going to actually solve the problems that we have as creative filmmakers, photographers, writers. You know, we need a solution that's a little bit niche, and this is it. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment, and otherwise, I will see you soon.